Hello and welcome to Using Recycled Old Star Trek Props with Ken and Will.
I love recycled old Star Trek props. If I could
Like,
remember
look at
the
our
button to
beeper.
bring out. I have a beeper!
So, when last we met, you were doing a little explore.
We were doing a little bit of exploring. There's a fire going on over there.
Yeah.
And it wants us to head in this direction. Or, you know, vaguely. Direction.
Yeah, we'll have to figure out what.
It's the just
some kind
you
of
know,
spooky.
It's cool ass computer signals. That's just the way she
oh,
goes.
It's green. It's real strong.
Yeah. Somewhere around here.
We gotta get over this rise.
Yeah.
Oh, there we go.
Gonna see.
Cause it's just giving us direction, but
yeah.
It doesn't know the map.
Does go that way. Does this bring
so
out
here?
Map.
Which direction is it pointing? Southwest?
West.
Now west. And it was southwest a bit ago.
So it wants us to go to the medicine wheel, basically.
Okay. Either way, if we get there, we can go down that way. So
yeah. So if we just head a little bit north and west, we should be able to get there pretty easily. Get out. There we go.
I'm also surprised they're able to effectively use this. I feel like whatever this instrument would be in real life, it would be incomprehensible.
It would be so inaccurate, just
Ooh,
leave you
south
in...
now.
Yeah, it's south now. So I think we just follow
So what's
path.
It say on the map?
I don't think there is. Yeah, there's nothing here.
So can we keep going?
We can.
Ooh. Big compass.
Oh. Strange beepus.
What?
Ah. It was trapped. We were foiled. Okay.
We should probably get out of here.
Probably.
I found some sort of supply bag, light camping gear, some clothes, and basics, but it was alarmed. I think that's what was making the receiver go haywire.
You're okay? It's not a trap or anything?
Yeah, it wasn't a
yeah,
bomb.
Fine, but there's also a set of keys here. I don't know why they'd be hidden out here. They say Shoshone National Forest, Cave 452. Is that the one in the canyon?
Yeah.
Hey, I know that one. They had
the
locked gate.
Took them.
And what the hell is in that cave?
Okay, let's just think.
Says the woman with a half a bottle of tequila in her belly.
Maybe they're panicking and we're preparing to beat it. The fire has them spooked and we have new walkie-talkies, so we have the upper hand.
Yeah, well, it's hard to feel like you have the upper hand when you're standing in the dark in the middle of the woods.
Oh.
Hey.
Back in your tower. Maybe you need a drink, too.
One-handed chop. Ah.
I am looking at a man standing in your lookout. And it's not...
I'm chopping down the tree.
Oh, my God. Go.
I'm going.
Hey, motherfucker. I heard you were up here. I got an axe.
Get ready for dad rage.
Dad rage engage. Creepy. No one here.
I don't see anyone up here.
She was just there.
Damn it.
What's on the door?
He foiled me. Oh. Picked up Walkman. Nice. All the other kids with their pumped up kicks. Oh, okay.
Tape of us talking down at the site. It sounds like it was recorded from somewhere nearby.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah. and it sounds like we were the ones who burned it down, and that it was your idea.
No.
We are screwed.
No!
Dee, just don't freak out, okay? Don't freak out.
Oh my god, what the fuck is happening, Henry?
I mean, freaking out is literally what caused us to get into this situation. What caused them to record the line of you saying burn it all down. Please stop replaying it over and over, God.
It's going to be okay. We haven't done anything wrong.
Someone claiming to be Henry in Two Forks called a lookout in another sector early this morning and said that I knew what caused the Wapiti Meadow fire. So, I just got off the horn with that lookout who's wondering what I know, or that I'm an arsonist, or that I'm fucking losing it. Furthermore, I bet you don't have the only tape of us from last night, so someone has evidence to back it up. We need to find out what someone's been keeping in that cave.
I'm going down there now.
We don't have a lot of time left out here, and if we don't find some fucking answers, when they lift us out of here, it's gonna be in handcuffs.
Yeah, that's fine.
It's fine. What was I going back to anyway?
Henry, you're going back to whatever you choose. Come on, this is serious.
I am serious. Look, we just tell the truth, and the chips will land where they land.
Yeah, I suppose you're right.
Yeah, let's put it on. Fuck it. Pick up our hat. We might die while we're up there. Might as well die with a wedding ring on. That way people have something to loot from our corpses.
Exactly.
Flapjack fire. Honestly, I should have a pair of keys or something to lock it.
Right?
Like,
considering everything that's happened.
I should really have a pair of keys. You know, maybe the bears in the forest learn how to open doors like raptors or some shit. I don't know, maybe. But I should really have that.
Maybe we're being blackmailed by a black bear.
Ooh.
Or grizzly mailed by a grizzly bear.
Okay, so was that the cave? 452?
That's the one.
Okay. So it looks like just we gotta go struggle. This way. Past the outhouse.
Yeah. Trusty poop hole.
Trusty poop hole. Damn it. Hold on. Look.
A destroyer you are.
Look, it's how you make sure that it's safe to poop. Just throw a baseball bat down, and if you hear a plop, you're good to plop.
You chuck it down, you hear boop. Ow!
Yeah, exactly. Then you apologize to the toilet gremlins and move about your day. Come back to poop some other time.
And that's why I, as a forest ranger, have a $300 a month baseball budget.
I've noticed that cutting down on the taco budget really cuts down on the baseball budget as well. I just like dropping off of these ledges.
Is that why there's so many reported baseball losses on Tuesdays?
You didn't actually make that call, right? To the other lookout? It just stuck in my craw. I let myself imagine.
Can't stop the fire? We'll never stop the fire. It'll always burn.
I just wish I hadn't.
I don't even know how to call anyone other than you. Please, rest assured, I would have found someone with a better sense of humor a long time ago.
Okay. Thanks.
There we go. Tactical levity.
Yeah. That's how I deal with all my stress.
Woo!
Woo! Anxiety. Making jokes.
My world's on fire. How about yours?
And here we go.
Into the hole.
Into the hole I go. Ah, yes, this is what I was thinking of. Was expecting that to be a little bit more difficult. Like, he puts it in and he tries to turn in and it just doesn't fucking turn.
Sorry, I just yanked my headphone out by mistake.
Yeah.
Jesus, so, this is a big cave.
That's a big drop. I don't want to do that. That seemed dangerous. We get shafts of light, which is nice.
I love a good shaft.
You know, this is how one of my Bloodwine characters died.
And at the bottom, there was a guy going, yeah!
Yeah! Well, that's gonna collapse. Huh. Shocking.
It's freezing in here.
Who am I telling this to? I'm gonna hold out my thing as if I'm talking to someone, but I don't even think I get a signal down here. Hello? Friends? Oh, hello. What the hell is that? A shoe! Well, now I'm curious about every hole that I come across.
Hmm.
Are there? There was one shoe, so presumably there is another shoe somewhere in this cave.
I think we have a flashlight.
Oh, yeah. We do have a flashlight.
Must be a lot of refracted light down here for it to still be, like, visible without one.
Yeah. I mean, there are a couple of beams of light. You know, makes a little bit of sense. Yeah. From the vent shaft, you know? Like there. Yeah, there we go.
Right again.
Yeah, that seems fine.
Hey, are you there?
Yeah, what is it? What did you find?
Nothing yet, because someone tried to trap me in there.
You saw someone?
No, someone slammed the gate behind me and then ran away. I found another way out, but if
I didn't even notice that.
So you didn't find anything?
No, there's a spot where someone had sunk an anchor, but the hardware's gone now.
I don't have any climbing equipment.
I just have my ropes. I'm gonna hike back to Two Forks and see if I can find anything that could double as an anchor to use in the spot.
Well, that doesn't sound dangerous.
A books! If we tie all the books together, they'll form a grappling hook.
Exactly.
Oh.
Delilah, I just found an outcropping that someone was using as a little fort. I think it was Brian Goodwin.
Really?
Yeah, he built himself a real castle. He was in the middle of really sprucing up the joint when they left.
A banner. Nice.
Bunch of rocks stacked up. You made a wall and a perimeter.
The clicking you hit there sounded like it's like, wow, a banner. Wow, an SMG.
You know, maybe he made it because he was afraid of them.
5 degrees north. Hell yeah.
Going through this crap, I get sick to my stomach.
Yeah. Sorry. He'd hide out here to read comics. The black band, his grief is his enemy's sorrow. Everyone this guy loves gets killed, so he honors them with a black armband, which gives him superpowers.
Huh.
Well, that's fucking dark.
I'd still read it. That he just leaves so much of his stuff out here.
Well, maybe they were in a hurry when they.
Yeah.
They almost got busted. Brian liked to go out on the railing of the tower and wave at the planes that dump water on fires, and I got a call because someone thought a kid was up in Two Forks. I lied and just said it was Ned. If I ratted him out, they would have been forced to leave, and I don't know, I guess I just felt like I was saving him from whatever shitty life Ned was gonna bring him back to. Not that it ended up mattering.
There's some grade A dork contraband here.
Oh, let's see his stats. 7 brain?
I
nice.
Found a data sheet for one. I think it's Gladius Silva, half elf.
Is that Brawn? Yeah, that seems Brawn. Brawn, agility, stamina, clever, knowledge, and moxie.
O'Brien created quite the fantasy world.
I think so.
Nice.
Gosh, Brian had everything he loved out there.
Oh, he's got a 15 saving throw for rod, staff, and wand. 7 armor, though. Wow, trash.
Some studded leather.
Yep, must be a level 1. Wait, do we have the level on here? Level 4, wow. 7 armor and a level 4? How the fuck has he survived?
Huh, Brian stole his dad's climbing gear. His...
Oh.
Anchors.
That's convenient.
Yeah, it is. I think he was gonna hide them in a cash box or something and never got around to it. He left a note for a
my address
and,
is
and 55
Foxtrot Lane.
Because he hated climbing?
Yeah, it sounds like
fucking doxing Brian.
Pushing him and pretending to lose his anchors was the easiest way to put a stop to it.
I hope it worked. God, what an asshole.
Yeah. Man, that is the sort of thing that would have caused me to catch a beating growing up.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't put it past old Ned.
There's a ham radio schematic here, something Brian was working on.
Yeah, I think that was the one thing Ned did do with him, you know, tinkering on stuff like that.
I totally know what this says. Yep, totally can read that.
There's also a postcard here from Brian to, I guess, his neighbor.
What's it say?
That he's with his dad and sorry he can't mow his lawn this summer.
Oh, gosh.
And also, he was worried his dad didn't know when school started. I'd say that's a lucky break if I were him.
Yeah, that doesn't surprise me. Ned didn't really seem like a, you know, with it dad.
Nice. Got some pittance.
We're slowly getting, like, an actual D&D backpack of tools.
Yeah.
Hey, remember that pack I found?
Back on your second day? Yeah.
I found a plan Brian drew about how he was going to get it back.
Oh, I'm sure it was quite elaborate.
It's some Wile E. Coyote stuff, I'll tell you that.
It's not bad. Not bad.
Yeah.
He's got some good ideas here.
Mm-hmm.
All he needs is basically like a D&D-esque heist, and he's good.
Mm-hmm. Brian was doing a science fair project about bouncing radio waves off of a meteor shower.
Ooh.
Poor kid left his homework?
Yeah. He must have been pretty smart, huh?
Yeah, sharper than a lot of the grown-up knuckleheads I'm used to, yeah.
You're saying I'm one of those knuckleheads, is that it?
I wasn't, but,
you calling me stupid?
About it.
Because I know lots of stuff.
Oh, please, drown me in your surplus of knowledge. I've been waiting all these years for a man as wise as you.
Why did that have, like, the same energy as someone sarcastically saying, like, daddy?
Sorry, boss. I found an old...
I don't think I've ever heard someone sarcastically say daddy. It's either been, like, to make someone cringe.
Yeah, like, you say it... You say it sarcastically, fully with the intent of making someone cringe. Because it doesn't matter whether you're saying it sarcastically or not. Mm-hmm. You're gonna make someone cringe. Man, this is a solid axe.
You know, if I can say something.
You can say several things.
We have to work towards more gender equal society because I love dick jokes.
Yeah.
But we need more versatility.
Oh, yeah.
But if you're just one dude making vagina jokes or boob jokes,
it doesn't work.
It doesn't work. Then you're just
really. I mean, we gotta
the
find
vagina
out.
Joke guy. Think?
Yeah, you don't want to be that guy.
There's a lot of comedic potential, you know?
Yeah.
Are you serious with
like, everyone likes to comment on the, like, phallic nature of things, but no one wants to comment on the yonic nature of things.
Mm-hmm. Like those cracks.
Exactly.
Yeah, especially now that I'm thinking about all the fun ways to be killed.
I'm sorry. Look, at least whoever locked you in doesn't know you've gotten out. Hopefully you find
I hope I don't get turned into a sculpture.
It'll be worth the risk.
No, it's fine. If I was going to be turned into a sculpture, it would have happened, like, in the cave.
Mm-hmm. Now we're in the woods, which is much safer.
Oh, yeah. It's much safer in the woods. Nothing bad ever happened. Speaking of which, where the fuck am I? Jesus Christ. Alright. I guess we're going back to the cave.
You know, you said your sense of direction wasn't that great,
oh,
but, like,
also,
you can use the tools. You should be camping at some point.
Looks like you didn't.
Nobody
did.
Nah, I'm good.
Some farmer's tractor for a joyride down in Riverton, and,
being outside sounds like a terrible idea.
You've done enough rowing in your day?
I've done enough. I'm good.
Yeah, I wonder if they know anything. If there's some way to ask them about whatever
I'm
happened.
I'm walking around with my cane being like, three-wheel drive! Let's do a three-day hike!
Yeah.
You're probably right.
I want to climb Mount Everest.
Like, before I started getting sick, it was like, man, sometimes working out and doing things, it's hard and you're out of energy and it hurts. I don't know. And then now it's like, that happens if I, like, get a bad night's sleep.
Yeah.
And then lift something wrong the next day. Compared to that, hiking seems easy.
Like, yeah. Fucking Christ, we're old.
Old and wobbly.
Old and very wobbly.
Like, intramural sports, I think, are good for kids, right? I think gym is essential. You should give them some
phys
ed.
Oh, yeah.
But at the same time, man, they kind of beat the shit out of us sometimes.
I'm going back in the cave. If someone locks me in this time. But mostly I'm doing it so I can drive a fit in here.
I'm getting another beer ripper.
Okay. Just want to make sure that down here is the correct area.
And I'm back.
I love the foley of you grabbing a beer. It is the most accurate foley I've ever heard of grabbing a beer.
Well, my last box was empty, so I had to open it up and it made a big jingle jingle.
Yeah. It's great.
Well, I mean, if you want some good Foley, get ready for this. On 5, 1, 2.
Oh, solid Foley. Nice. Now them's a beer opening sound.
I'm glad that this, even though the caves here are pretty roomy, not that I've got much caving experience. There's very few caves in Ontario based on like geology. And all of them are down here where it's all limestone.
Yeah.
So I don't really have an excuse. But like
shit.
Caves are freaky.
Caves are very freaky.
Oh god.
Oh. Okay. And moving on from tragedy.
Like, that's the freaky part about caves.
Yeah, like that's the reason why I don't do caving.
And like you can end up somewhere where people can't get you.
Yeah. Yeah, way too many fucking stories that you hear, like the horror stories of caving, are just like, mm-hmm. Yeah, and so they went down a weird path and they were just discovered like 2 weeks later, dead.
Mm-hmm. Or the situations where it's like you can maintain verbal contact but just can't get them out, and then
God.
A week later they die or whatever.
Yeah. That's
you gotta be careful. Stuff. Even just like hiking and canoeing and stuff like that, it can be really dangerous.
Oh god, yeah. All of that is super fucking dangerous. And that is why I live inside. I live indoors. We no go outside.
So, like, yeah. Like, I've heard people theorize about, like, missing person cases. About, yeah. Like, what if there's just all these serial killers and stuff like that. It's like, truth is, like, if you go for a walk in the wrong direction and slip and no one hears you and you hit your head, like, you...
Yeah, that's...
You can die.
That's
and
just
you can
it.
Die somewhere you don't get seen.
Yeah.
Right?
Oh, yeah. Super fucking easy. And that is why I have decided to become the neighborhood goblin that greets people with my presence whenever I go and get the mail. I just emerge from the house completely disheveled and shamble over to the community mailbox and get my mail and then shamble back. Occasionally you'll see me in like the briefest of moments.
Yeah, I still like outside. I just don't really do caves or climbing.
Yeah, that's fair.
Hey, D.
There you are. I've been worrying my ass off.
You need to call search and rescue.
What?
There's a body in the cave. It's Brian Goodwin.
You gotta be fucking kidding me. How does that... What? I don't... How?
Climbing, I think, or made to look like a climbing accident.
I'm gonna say
what it was. He was probably exploring the cave.
Optimism.
Maybe his rope gave out. But whoever locked me in there probably didn't even know about him. I'm sorry, Delilah. I'm so sorry.
He'd be alive if I had told someone he was out here. I don't know where he'd be, but I can assure you it would not be rotting at the bottom of that cave. There's nothing to say. Hike back. I think we're leaving tomorrow anyway.
You good, Delilah? Your past choices coming back to haunt you a little bit?
And even then, like... There's a certain level of, like... diffuseness of guilt,
mm-hmm.
where like if everyone who has a tangential involvement is somehow guilty of something,
yeah,
then like
no,
everyone's guilty, right?
Up.
Yeah.
Well, there's gonna be a lot more. The service says this.
Any
is
like his school would be guilty, his dad would be guilty, his mom would be guilty, everyone would be guilty.
Well, the two fires merged into one unmitigated disaster.
You gotta have room for, like, partial guilt, right?
Yeah.
Where it's not really your fault, but you can have regrets about what part you played.
Yeah, exactly.
About what?
About what happened to Brian.
I don't have much to say. I'm fine.
Pick up Shelly DeBall.
I'm sad. I'm whatever.
Bye, Sarge.
I keep thinking about him down there, and I just want to get far away from here.
What can I do?
You have
just have to wait for the helicopters.
Okay. Good.
Until then,
question.
Could you follow that signal? Maybe.
Holy crap. Yeah. Oh my god.
We don't know what it is. It could be nothing.
Yeah, it could also be whoever was listening to us. Whoever made the tape.
Oh, I think I saw it in the back of your hand.
Okay. Yeah, look, you should pack up everything you need in case we get the call and you can't come back.
All right, look, if something happens...
I'll remember you.
Oh, well, that's nice.
You're just gonna assume that I'm dead. Oh, photo with Julia. Yeah, no, gotta put that away. I'm sad I can't take this mug with me.
Yeah. It would be a good piece of memorabilia, but...
Right? I can't take the books. I can't even take this thermos. I will take this toilet paper, though. Fine. I think I've got everything. Yeah, we'll see.
I think that's it, yeah.
Whew, this is an unmitigated disaster.
Yep.
Just look at all that fire.
This. I'm excited for the thaw. I want to go back outside for work again.
I keep thinking that it's going to thaw, and it just never fully does.
Mm-hmm. It comes and it goes, and it comes and it goes.
It's the joys of Canadian spring, where one day we have a complete whiteout blizzard, and the next day all the snow is gone.
Have you seen the list of Canadian seasons that's 12 seasons long?
No. I've only seen the one that's two, winter and construction.
Alright, let me see if I can find it. Because it's made its way around. It's like a Tumblr post or something.
Right.
And I want to make sure, there we go. It's popular enough that I found it.
Nice.
So it goes winter, full spring, second winter, spring of deception, third winter, mud season, actual spring, summer, false fall, second summer 1 week, and then actual fall.
Nice. Just picturing
the so far? We're going downhill.
Yeah.
All right. Well, I just got word that they're coming to get us.
Heading over towards Jonesy Lake. We're really going into the smoke here.
Brian.
I'll coordinate with the evac team and let you know when to head towards the tram. It's north. Far. Past where you found that cut back in May. There's an emergency tram out there that will let you hike to the rendezvous point in my lookout.
I keep saying Shoshone, but what... because it's the Shoshone National Forest. I keep saying Colorado, but what state are they in, actually?
I have no idea.
I forget, I think it's Wyoming.
That would make sense. That's as valid as any other U.S. state, because I have no idea.
Because I've heard that apparently, if you want to see, a lot of natural beauty, and you're not, necessarily native to the U.S., and you want to see it all in, one trip, you don't do a massive cross-country thing. You go to Wyoming, because it's just, it's... got the support, but it's not well traveled enough that too many people are there, and they have they intersect with a whole bunch of different biomes, so there's what's the word I'm looking for, there's mountains, there's lowlands, it's pretty close to Yellowstone.
There's a tracking color tied to it. Someone was leading me here, and there's another tape.
I know those collars are spooky, but I bet they're for, bears.
Yeah, yeah. that does not look like it's gonna fit Henry.
Yeah, hi, Henry. Hey, you better find this before it burns up. We've been causing each other a lot of headaches. Now I gotta go stake out a site that's as fit for living as the one you're about to find. You'll get it when you see it. You can't blame me for keeping an eye on you. Not after bumping into you back in May. Down by the cave, for croc's sake.
Scoot, are you okay?
Worrying about you finding anything out. That's right when everything went shit house with you two. You guys don't know anything about having kids. All right, nobody knows nothing. It ain't Andy and Opie walking down a lake to fish every afternoon. It ain't Mayberry. But you gotta know I didn't kill him. All right, we were climbing. I was teaching him. Brian was uneducated in the way to do anything. He just fucking didn't sink his anchor the right way. You know, I thought about going back, having to answer questions and having to get him put in the ground, and I didn't see the point. Don't come looking for me. Sorry about your wife.
What happened to my wife?
Dementia?
Oh, yeah, that's fair. I thought something else had happened to my wife. Like, hey, I intercepted some mail that I didn't bother give to you.
Survival bunker with radios and everything. Like, he made it all up.
This is the partial guilt thing coming in, right? Like, yeah. Lila's not really guilty, but it's fair for her to feel guilt.
Yeah.
Ned didn't kill his son, but his actions that he chose led to negligence.
Yeah.
Killed his son, right?
Goodman, like, was the one who wrote
the guilt isn't as partial for Ned. Sight.
Observational traits. Fuck. Guilty. You know, if I'm working off a typewriter, I'd probably write fuck a couple of times into my reports.
Mm-hmm.
Just stealing everything. Oh, the shit from the teen's campsite.
God.
What? To a rad bad mega dad. Aw, yeah.
I'm keeping this. Oh, I'm a rad dad. Rad bad mega dad.
Brian was a nice looking kid.
When he wasn't decaying.
At the same time, like, there's the fear of, like, going to jail, but, like, living like this?
Come on, yeah, like.
He's better in jail.
Yeah. You know, you can actually have access to therapy.
Then again, I guess if it's like a whole don't fence me in thing and you don't like people, then you run off into the woods.
Yeah. You know, well, I think I've decided Sarge's backstory.
You should see some of the stuff he was working on. I guess he had a lot of time on his hands.
No one is talking to me now.
This boombox looks familiar.
Ooh.
It's the one that I trashed.
He was rigging up stolen batteries.
That campaign's a fun one.
The campaign is very
running
fun.
Bloodline hasn't run because, like, the difference between running an off-camera campaign and an on-camera campaign is, like, a decent bit.
Yeah, they're very different things.
It's gonna burn. And I can't find a good 4 reliable people to, like, do a stream with, right? Because, like, just it's a lot to ask of someone.
Yeah.
And we had a good run, you know?
Yeah.
But, like, basically everyone from that campaign is, like,
got a radio playing base station up here.
Yeah.
And, like,
he was listening to us on that.
It gives you more freedom. You can play Sarge, who's Abe Simpson and has, like, long rambles.
Long rambles and just the dumbest shit, but also, like, randomly decided to steal shit last time. Because reasons, I guess. Oh, that's a nice wind chime. Oh, hello. Radio logs.
He wrote down everything he did to us. And everything he did every day. He was scared shitless.
I bet.
Like that D drunk again.
It's relatable.
Hit against each other. Yeah, that didn't really work. I didn't for a second believe it was Delilah.
Yeah, like...
Like, when Delilah's having a bigger freak out than I am, it's like, yeah, alright. Alright. Mm-hmm. It's Mama Grizz.
Too much personality to be an act.
Yeah, right?
That's why I like weirdos. You can trust a weirdo.
Oh, yeah.
Because they're just, you know what they're hiding. They're a weirdo. And yeah. They're not really hiding it. They're just a weirdo. And that's fine. It's the fucking normal people where it's like, what do you have in your basement?
Fucking.
What?
Fucking Gravity Falls had the one normal guy. I think his name was like Tad Strange or something like that.
I just started rewatching that today.
Yeah.
It's such a good series.
So fucking you know good.
Hot take. You know what made it so fucking good?
What?
It ended, and it was yes. supposed to end, and yes. it ended.
Yes. I Holy fully, shit. I fully believe that series that have a full scope in mind at, like, creation are fantastic. And, like, they are so yeah. far and above everything else. Like, even some TV shows, like, my personal favorite TV show is the TV show Chuck that aired, like, in 2008. Mm. They, like, tried to keep the series going as long as possible, but they knew how they wanted to end it. They knew the entire fucking time how they wanted to end it. And in fairness, yeah. the show ended, like, 3 times.
And you can design something to work, like, in perpetuity, but it's yeah. the same thing. You gotta have an opener, and it's gotta end.
Yeah.
And, like, you have to keep it fresh sometimes by changing the formula, but it's iteration on... familiar things that makes a series that's really like
yes
in perpetuity like nice right
yeah and something like Gravity Falls knew exactly what it wanted to be.
Mm-hmm.
It was we are going to be a show about kids investigating like the spooky camp, and we got these weird books, and that's it. That's the plot. They ran with it and it was great. All right, so I need to get to the evac point.
Which way do you want to go out of the two arrows?
I mean, I could go by the creepy cave up through Beartooth, or I could just cut through Thunder Canyon and go up, which is currently the path of least resistance here.
Might as well.
But yeah.
All right, we're going on an adventure.
I'm going on an adventure.
Man, this is gonna be so bad for your lungs.
Oh god, yeah, this is brutal.
Fire, relieved that we're not crazy, that there wasn't some conspiracy. But I'm not. He was a sweet kid. With a shitty father who hid out here like a coward after dumping him in a hole.
Yeah.
He wasn't a good dad.
No fucking shit. Thinking about it.
You didn't do anything wrong.
Yes, I did. And now I've got to decide whether I tell people that he's down there so they can retrieve the body or not. And if I do, I'm going to be asked about Ned Goodwin.
D?
Oh, fuck.
Is that a helicopter?
Yeah, hold on.
Wait, what? How did I do that? How the fuck did I do that?
Yes, here, yeah. Yeah, he's coming.
Oh, maybe it was the S and you accidentally 180.
Okay, 1 second.
Fucking.
Hey, they're here, but they're making rounds. They'll come back. I think I'm gonna go with them.
Yeah, go.
Yeah, that's a good idea. It's dangerous here, and if anything were to happen, then that would be on me, so.
And I'm currently lost, so.
Yeah,
cut out.
You sure that's okay?
I said it was.
Alright, I should go.
It's have too bad flight. This is an effectively right, unsequelable game.
I know, right?
Because I would love to have, like, a similar mystery in a different forest with a different character.
Yeah.
But, like, then it would be Firewatch 2.
Yeah.
And, like, I don't know.
That yeah, it's one of those games that like beg like people that love this game, I'm sure beg for a sequel, but like isolated
Well,
stories are isolated stories, and I will
yeah.
always hold to that.
That being
Like,
said, I don't know if you know this, but this actually is like a multiple ending, multiple
oh yeah,
event
I figured as
story.
much.
Like it cycles out dialogue. There's even like this stream. I played through this game like three, four times, and I even heard new dialogue this time.
Oh
Like,
yeah?
yeah.
What hadn't you heard before?
Oh, I don't remember. It's just, and
It's
that's the best
just little
part is that
things?
it's just little things, which is great for like keeping Delilah and Henry charming.
Yeah.
'Cause they both have a charm,
Yeah.
right?
And I'm sure you could play this game being a complete fucking asshole to Delilah.
Yeah, like both of them are 40, 50 year olds with no kids and a sense of humor. Like they've
Yeah.
got the vibe.
Yeah. You know, it would be nice if they came to my tower. That'd be cool. Then I gotta go all the
I
way to
am
Delilah.
curious about like how the guy ate, because there were all those cans, but like what do? Just go to a general store and buy canned goods and come back into town? Like,
I mean, I think he probably stole from campers, and how
but
the
like there can't
fuck
be
did
enough
I do that?
cans.
Whatever, we're
Like,
on
it
this
would
path
make
now.
so much more sense to hunt and fish, but there wasn't any evidence of that. Or
Yeah,
forage,
yeah.
but also no evidence of that. Because all of those hobbies you need equipment for.
Yeah.
Imagine being a hunter-gatherer and hearing me describe those things as a hobby. Being like, bitch, I have to do this every day!
Hell are you talking about? I wake up at the crack of dawn. I have to chop fire for firewood. I have to gather all these berries. I have to hunt a fucking wild boar. Like, I've been tracking that thing for 3 fucking days. 3 goddamn days. And you're saying hobby?
Man, Shem, pass me the wheat ferment. I can't deal with this shit. I've been hunting wild boar. My wife's complaining because her hands hurt from the berries. We only caught two rabbits last week, and I'm still hungry. It's fucking bullshit.
So awful, man. I'm gonna get turned around if I. Yeah, okay.
And Forest Burns was
Just
never
keep
seen
heading
again.
north. Oh, I'm heading northwest. I have to keep myself on track.
It is nice the way that they build like that artificial environment.
Yeah.
Like it's actually like a couple of little enclosed levels with a couple of obstacles, but they have like the vibe of when you're walking around and like there's things that seem like trails, and
Things
then
that
some
don't,
things are
yeah.
just like, yeah.
Nope.
Remember it was like English class, we were reading Lord of the Flies, and they kept talking about pig runs, and we were like, what is that? And they're like, when in the forest, like when a whole bunch of like pigs go down a trail, like they'll make it. And I was like, oh my god, that's how those keep happening. I thought they were just a bunch of asshole foresters giving us shitty fake trails all the time that aren't wide enough.
I mean that does sound like it would be a real thing. Like I'd fully believe that.
When they do it by design, though, they usually have a nice little like high path, low path thing, or it's a
Yeah.
nice little loopy.
Yeah.
So we're going to fix it.
Yeah. Okay,
We're almost
I
there.
just gotta go west now.
It's nice that this thing replaces our compass somewhat.
Yeah, it's a little bit easier to read. Where is the path west?
Where are we on the map? Oh, there we go. Locked trail.
I'm coming. Again, the block trail is how I got lost previously, but I'm sure this is fine. Yeah, this seems fine.
Could you imagine that supply drop if you were one of the other lookouts and someone took your fucking box?
Just like, well, I guess I'm fucked?
Especially, imagine, like, you're friends with the ranger. You've been working there for like 20 years. They were like, hey, the last time I was in town, I got some whiskey. I passed you a couple of bottles. You get there and your box is gone. Then there's some new guy like, oh, sorry. I don't know what I was doing.
I just grabbed the wrong box by mistake. Like, bitch, no, you give me that fucking whiskey.
Take Delilah's food just to troll her.
Yeah. Hey, there's the thingamabob. I don't know why I'm doing this. She left. I told her to leave. But it was not safe.
Loading screen.
Oh.
How mysterious.
Nice. Do we get to see Delilah's area now?
Yeah. You can creep on Delilah.
Nice! I love me a Delilah creeping. She also does not have a lock, I'm assuming. If I don't have a lock, it would be bullshit if she did. Oh, this is a nice place. Odd.
FDR. He was the guy who established the National Park Service in the U.S.
It's still a little bit odd. Lucien's Gambit?
Maybe as Canadians, but I feel like everyone who, like, works this kind of job in the U.S. must have a little portrait of FDR. Because he's his own, like, history weird figure.
True. Ooh, an apple slice.
And some Biff!
I love Biff!
It's us!
Oh, she drew us, right!
the little curly mustache we described.
Yeah, that's like great. That's fucking great. Keeping that. Man, she's so much tidier than ours.
And yet, like, so much more shit because of the tidiness. Like, it's so cozy in here.
Yeah. This is great.
Probably put on the headset.
Yeah, probably.
Oh my god, she stole a pork pawn sign.
Nice. Oh my god, you're right.
Hi. Yeah, it's me.
She's taking pictures, too.
I'm back at the staging area.
Red, Colorado plates.
Yeah. It's a piece of shit.
Yeah, I mean, not wrong.
Well, yeah.
I think there might be a raccoon living in it.
Make sure he's
That's
comfy,
Chuck.
I guess.
Hey, it shouldn't take long for the helicopter to reach you.
Okay.
There's a debrief in a situation like this. Lots of questions.
Shit. So, taking stock, we found out an old lookout killed his only son and decided to become a lonely hermit.
Yes.
And we prevented one fire?
Basically started another.
Okay, so that's a wash.
Oh, yeah, they even out.
Doing every summer from now on that isn't this.
You're not coming back?
No. And you'll have to...
Me neither. I don't know what's next.
Tell you what, why don't you choose for me, and I'll choose for you.
It's really weird depending on, like, the industry, because sometimes something like this is like,
maybe.
Yeah, you can never work here again.
Or yeah,
another one is
yeah.
like, yeah, this stuff happens and it's really bad. But, like, now you're seasoned.
Oh, I don't even fucking know.
maybe move to Santa Fe. Open a jade emporium with your sister.
I'd be trading cute ski bombs for yoga retreat hippies, but maybe that's not all bad.
What's the margarita situation?
I mean, yeah.
So what about me?
But, Lila, you like tequila.
I think you should go
down to New Mexico.
Yeah.
And then you can figure it out. Maybe put that typewriter to good use. Give me a sexy accent or something if you write about this.
I am. Yeah.
You gotta go see her.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, sure.
Henry,
my response to anything that when my parents tell me I need to do stuff. Yeah, sure. Yep.
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 Uh-huh.
Yep.
You're right. I mean, I think you're right.
Good.
When I get back, maybe I could.
We shouldn't focus on this summer. Next year we'll roll around, and then the year after that, and then it's just a... I don't know. My Aunt Judy called it a pause in the hallway of time.
Did your Aunt Judy smoke a lot of pot?
Yeah.
It's very likely.
Take her advice too.
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll see.
There's the helicopter.
They'll land back where you hiked up. Good luck, Henry.
I'll see you when I see you.
Yeah, okay.
Incredibly awkward.
Sounds good.
Bye. I'll visit you in Santa Fe.
Well, I don't know. You don't seem like the city type. What if... Okay, look, I know this is a bit of an idea, but you've seen my truck, right? And there's this lake that we could park at that's like 80 miles from Santa Fe. You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
Parked out by the lake, 80 miles from Santa Fe, where
yeah.
I'm sitting out here.
Yeah, it makes perfect sense. What if I just stayed here? Probably go down.
That video is so good because it's like it wasn't someone who makes memes that made it. It was a country musician that made it as a meme, like while recording an album, which is why it's so high quality.
Hi. Hello. Out. Hi. Out.
Hello.
A moment where you have to try and like seem competent in front of people. Let's go, buddy.
First person we've actually, like...
seen.
Yeah, in a way that wasn't sus or from far away.
Little do we know, that was Ned! Good job, Campo.
Yeah, that was Firewatch.
That was a solid game.
Yeah.
Oh, I enjoyed that.
Came out when people were complaining about walking simulators.
Yeah.
Like, man, this is not the same kind of game.
It is not. It is walking simulator in the best fucking way.
Yeah, which is funny because it's a hiking simulator.
Yeah, it's a hiking simulator. No one likes walking. People like hiking.
Ooh. We got stuff from the photo dome. We didn't use all of our
Yeah, cameras. I didn't use the full camera. My tree!
Yeah!
And the trash teenage tent.
Yeah!
I should have taken a picture of the corpse.
Hey, cops! You probably want this.
Yeah, this is probably pretty crucial shit.
That's a quality picture.
That is a quality picture. That's going National Geographic right there. Yeah, I don't know. This game is really fucking pretty.
Yeah, and it's like Breath of the Wild where they err on the side of simplicity instead of on the side of like...
I look like every 40-year-old YouTuber.
Hello and welcome to Flat Earth Vlogs. There's one that's just a thumb.
Yeah. Oh, and then we got Brian's.
Oh, these are Brian's.
Yeah.
So that's Ned.
Yeah. Yeah, this is Brian. We got his photo earlier. Wonder who took this one. The ground, apparently.
Well, with those cameras, you usually had a default 10-second timer that you could
put on. So this is probably resting on a rock.
Yeah. I am really surprised that disposable cameras aren't, like, a Gen Z novelty item. Because, like, those would be so fun as, like, an activity.
Like, instant cameras should be a novelty item. Like, yeah. they genuinely should be. Because when I was working at Tim Hortons, and we found an instant camera that a customer had left behind. Poor tourist. Mm-hmm. Poor tourist left behind their Instamax. And they were just taking pictures. I have one of the Instamax photos that they took of me while I was working, because my managers were little shits and would just, you know, stand around goofing off while I was the one doing the work. So it'd be like they were taking photos of fucking everybody. They were loving it. I'm like, this, yeah, it's a fucking novelty.
I just noticed that it's what was I gonna say? It's not our tower, it's Delilah's that's in the opener there.
Oh yeah? Oh yeah, you're right. It is. Huh. Yeah, that's Firewatch.
That's Wyoming Simulator.
That's Wyoming Simulator. And I think I know, based on this, I think I know what we're going to play next. We might even give it a couple of rounds. But yeah.
That's the Shoshone National Forest is in Wyoming.
Oh, good to know. Good to know.
Well, I'm excited. Do I get a spoiler or is it a surprise?
I mean, I've talked about it a little bit with you, but I'll leave it a surprise for stream.
Oh.
Yeah. Ooh. Yeah. But it's the same art style. Mm. I think different developers. I would have to confirm that. But yeah. And you know, it aligns with a lot of the stuff that we do.
Yeah.
A lot of the fuckery that we do on the Ken and Will show.
Oh, yes, sir. Ken and Willery.
Yes.
Will and Kennery.
Our brand. It's very on brand for us.
Our brand.
Anyway, so yeah, I guess we ended off here because I didn't have anything else prepared. I wasn't expecting us to finish it that quick.
Yeah, me too. I stopped you last time and I was like hesitant to stop you because I was like, we could probably push a bit forward, but I thought we had a bit more.
Yeah.
Oh well, early night.
Yep, early night.
It's, yeah, we didn't stream for very long at all.
No, we've only been streaming for an hour. But yeah, that's good every once in a while. All right, so yeah, as always, thank you everyone for watching, and we'll see you all next time. Bye bye.
Yeah.